Good morning, everyone. Thank you for joining us for this session. This session is titled Teaching Reading Comprehension in a Media-Rich Multifaceted DLIFLC Environment, presented by Dr. Paulina DeSantis, who used to be faculty development senior specialist here at DLI, and now she's working with continued education distance learning.
Thank you. And thank you all for coming for this last morning session. So the weather is so nice, so hope you're not too hungry or get hungry over the next 30, 45 minutes. So why reading? Yeah. So reading is a crucial component for attaining high level proficiency in a foreign language, and it is one of the three skills that our students need to acquire to meet their mission needs. And nowadays, I think you all agree that the ability to read online has become essential because we're all engaged in technologically mediated discourse. Information and communication technology has revolutionized virtually every aspect of our life and work. And if we look at the current statistics of the world internet usage, you can see that 57.3% of the world uses internet, which is over 1,000% growth from the beginning of the century. And if we look just at North America, it's even higher. Nearly 90% of population uses internet, which is around 200% growth. And of course, internet use entails online reading to some extent, yes? These rapid changes in information and communication technology have reshaped the meaning of reading. And please take a minute to look at the definition of reading as formulated by the Program for International Student Assessment over the 2009, 2012, 2013. So in the cyber age, reading implies not only understanding, but using or doing something with what we read, yes? Reflecting on what we read emphasizes the notion that reading is interactive. So readers draw on their own thoughts and experiences when they engage with texts. And in most current definition of reading, the 2018 definition, the word written has been removed. So I guess it's not there because it endorses the fact that reading texts are more than just traditional print. And even the terminology that we use nowadays when we talk about reading reflects these changes. I use the terms in each box interchangeably, and I believe there are other options that can be added to each box. At the same time, the words in each box have some nuances of use. I will not go deeper into the terminology. I just want to mention that, for example, screen reading doesn't necessarily mean reading hypertext, yes? So students read textbooks in a digital format which do not necessarily have hyperlinks. So I just want you to keep in mind that there are a lot of variables when we talk about online multifaceted reading environment. According to the 2016 Pew Research Center survey, Book Reading 2016, American adults remain hybrid consumers because they read both online and in print. About 4 in 10 read, for example, news online, and only 2 in 10 get news, if they get news, from print newspapers. Research also demonstrated that Americans are more likely to read for the purpose of researching a specific topic, and that younger adults are more likely than older adults to read for work, for school, or research a topic of interest. So even though digital information is nowadays referred as pages, so we turn the pages, yes? So the speed, the structure, and presentation of web texts are very different from traditional texts in terms of organization patterns, modality, and linearity. In general, hypertexts are described as being non-linear, even though there are some which are organized similarly to print texts. So you can move through the text in two directions, yes, forward and backward. Readers of print texts, they can flip through some pages in a different order. And of course, most are designed in a linear fashion and sequentially from the first word of the book to the last. The information in hypertexts can be reached in different sequences, and different readers can have different routes, which may be different from the routes of the author of the text. One word might lead via hyperlink to an entire new piece of reading. And also the visual elements of web texts is another typical feature which adds to the complexity of reading. Traditional text forms typically include a combination of two types of media. Yes, it's print and two-dimensional graphics. And electronic texts, they can integrate a range of symbols, multiple media formats, icons, all those animated symbols, cartoons, even virtual reality environment. So images and sounds, they are combined with written texts and they create new ways of conveying meaning. So web-based environments are interactive by their just very nature, as opposed to static words on a print page. As students navigate through various pathways, they construct a personal adaptation of the information, and in many cases, a reader can become a writer by contributing to the web text. Conventional texts, on the other hand, present information shaped by the author, and readers have little choice but to follow the author's intended plot or expository structure. A further dimension of hypertexts is that they are dynamic and they can be updated regularly or frequently, so the reader encounters a different text each time it is accessed, and sometimes it's not even available there anymore. Yes? In essence, such texts have an unfixed dynamic existence. And in dynamic texts, typically only a fraction of the available text can be seen at one particular time. And often the length of the text available to the reader is unknown. And that's what happens during their, for example, DLPT tests. So they don't know how long the text is. So to explore the extent to which our DLI instructors utilize online texts, as compared to print texts in teaching reading to get the students to high levels of linguistic proficiency, I conducted the pilot study, which aimed to answer these two questions. And the findings of this study are based on the review of IRC mammals, and you're all familiar with IRC mammals, yes. So as a senior faculty development specialist, I conducted IRC observations and compiled mammals, and I examined about 50 of my mammals and selected a total of 38 that focused on reading comprehension. So the print texts were hard copies of textbooks and authentic articles that were printed from the internet, while online texts were soft copies of textbooks and the same articles that students accessed via their computers. So the results of this pilot demonstrated that in teaching reading, instructors use both online and print texts during the delivery of the lessons. However, the only 10% of the instructors used online reading texts, and 13% used both digital and paper reading texts within the same hour. So the result of this pilot, like many other research findings, indicate that online reading is greatly underused in teaching reading. So based on this pilot, I explored the reasons of why online texts are underused in general, not only in DLI context, but in general. But of course, I was focusing on our DLI setting in particular. And the main study research questions were here. The beliefs of the faculty and the strategies. Yes? So, of course, you're all familiar with our DLI setting, yeah? So we all have internet access, smart boards. The participants of the study were 40 instructors from different schools who spent at least 5 years at DLI. And I conducted informal 25-minute interviews, and here are the questions that we discussed with the participants. And I will show you the responses of the faculty so to each of these six questions. So for example, the first question, what types of texts they use. So regarding the print, you can see they use textbooks and reference books, dictionaries, hard copies or cut and paste online texts. So they use the same kind of in digital format, and I actually like, so several faculty members mentioned that they use scripts of listening comprehension texts, so they use them also for reading. As for the purpose of using print versus digital, so they prefer to use print to reinforce certain vocabulary, to reinforce grammar, and some of the reasons that they state is because these texts are already selected for specific vocabulary and grammar, yeah? So that's why they prefer to use them. So as for the digital, the purpose is to get information from different sources for research projects, or to prepare a report on current world events, so they usually assign them as homework. So they use scripts to check their listening comprehension, and they use digital format to select topics for discussion, like for example, ask students to look at headlines of the current news. As for the what determines their decision, so they said that they use print based on the learning objectives of the lesson. They think that it's easier to work with, easier to take notes. So due to time constraints of the lesson, prefer to use print. Often students request hard copies. And also, of course, we all know that, yes, that not always technology is reliable. So they prefer to have hard copies. So as for the digital, they motivate students at early stage because they show that students can work with authentic texts. They use them to change the routine of the class, or some mentioned that they use digital when they have no time to prepare and print. So then the students read online. So as for the advantages based on our faculty, so the thing that the advantages of digital reading is for students are used to digital format outside the classroom, that they're more appealing, that the materials, of course, are more up to date. Some just mentioned that they want to go green instead of, and of course there is shortage of paper. It gives them more authentic experience, helps them to prepare for DLPT. They also think that digital reading motivates students and helps them learn more content. That students can perform other tasks in addition to reading as they're exposed to digital format. They also, some mentioned that it saves time, paper, and effort, and of course helps students for their future work assignments. As for the disadvantages of digital reading, they mentioned that the students are easily distracted. Yes, all those ads and pictures, they distract them from the content. That searching is time consuming, especially in the class hour. That they say that it's more difficult to collect texts. For example, if they want to review materials, so collecting texts, they still prefer to collect them in print format. And if they just save links in digital formats, then they're not available there anymore. So they say that sometimes they can be demotivational because you cannot control the amount of unknown vocabulary and grammar when they're exposed to authentic texts. So some mentioned that they cannot take notes, but actually you can take notes online, but it's just more time consuming. And without teacher's guidance, the sources are often unreliable, so they don't know where their students go if you just ask them to search online. Yes, they often end up reading some hoax pages where the information is completely wrong. Yeah? So, as for the strategies for digital reading, so 40% of the respondents said that they don't teach any specific strategies because there is no need, so they use the same strategies as for traditional reading, that the students know more how to use the internet and they know it better than the teachers, and of course that the students are savvy with technology, so they don't need our help. So, however, the rest, the 60% of those who use strategies, they are, as you can see, all of them mentioned that they introduce top-level domains in the target language. Practically all of them tell them not to click on all hyperlinks. Synthesize information from different sources. To select keywords when they search for information. They tell them to scan web pages to locate information. Only 7 provided specific engines for translation. They recommend them to create lists of favorites and tell them to avoid distractors and also to activate prior knowledge. So if you look at the online strategies that our teachers tell the students how to work with online texts, the researchers show the critical online reading strategies which are practically the same, yes? So these are the key strategies that researchers mention when reading online. So the only difference between this and what our faculty, the respondents to my study, mentioned is that they do not explicitly teach the strategies. So only 2 of the faculty said that they tell them how to. So that they just tell them, oh, find information using this search engine, or avoid distractors, yes? But the research says that it's important not just to mention the strategies, but to explicitly show them how to do that, yes? So, but research suggests also that proficient offline readers are not necessarily proficient online readers, and vice versa. And most researchers agree that skills required to comprehend hypertexts are different to print texts, and that they need to be refined by learners and educators alike. The hypertexts are embedded in documents and internet pages, and research has found that they make different demands on the reader than traditional texts. So many web-based environments introduce a new set of cognitive barriers that can cause competent readers of conventional texts to be cognitively overloaded and emotionally frustrated. And hypertext and interactive features can offer too many choices and too many animations that may distract and disorient otherwise strong readers. The internet may have a negative impact on attention and reading comprehension. For example, Laurie Henry's 2006 study showed that going from about 5 hyperlinks per page to about 11 per page reduced college students' text comprehension, which was assessed by multiple choice tests. And she attributed this fact to the decision-making process required by each hyperlink. So deciding whether to click or not takes time. And she also found that the major obstacle for students was that they were unable to successfully limit their search process, and the information, there was too much information for them to sift through. So decision-making process may not only be time-consuming, but it may reduce comprehension of surrounding text. And some researchers also complain that we have become superficial readers, that the speed at which information is presented prevents the deep reading required to fully comprehend the text. And finally, the background knowledge of the reader can partially determine the effect hyperlinks have on comprehension. So the more background knowledge they have, the less they click, yes? Virginia Clinton, and this is the most recent study I found a few weeks ago and added to my presentation, because I was just looking at separate studies, but Virginia Clinton conducted a meta-analysis, and she consolidated the findings on reading performance, reading times, and metacognition. She selected 33 independent studies that were conducted over this period, and which included over 2,000 participants. So all studies used an experimental design with random assignments, and some of the participants were children, while some were adults, but they all had acquired foundational reading skills. So all studies were published in English, and none included participants with learning disabilities or visual impairment. So what she found was that, of course, there were a lot of studies conducted on the topics, yes? And that reading from screens is very common. And that there are many concerns about effects of medium on reading, like I mentioned earlier. At the same time, the new findings that she found based on this meta-analysis, that there is small significant benefit of reading from paper on reading performance, yes? So it's small, but it is still significantly, statistically significant, yes? Also, she found that reading from screens had a negative effect on reading performance relative to paper. specifically, what is interesting, that it was limited to expository texts, which are the texts that we use. These are the factual texts, the news articles, that's what we'll use, some factual information, yes? But there was no difference with narrative texts like stories or novels, yes? So also there was no reliable differences found for reading time. And at the same time, readers had more accurate judgment of their performance from paper compared to screens. So the metacognition.
How come? Why is it?
Well, because when they read, well, again, so we don't know why, but because when they read, they can analyze, I guess, more their performance. With the screens, they
overwhelmed probably with somebody's entrance.
So, but these are the new findings based on this meta-analysis. So her conclusion is that readers may be more efficient and aware of their performance when reading from paper compared to screens. And to better understand why paper has reading benefits, we need to conduct more research. So it's still not clear why, but the benefits are there even though they are small. Yes? So at the same time, understanding how information is interlinked and interconnected is a foundation skill and an essential part of reading in today's society. Yes? So hypertexts are ubiquitous, and for teachers to be able to assist and guide their students, they first and foremost need to be informed and involved in web-based teaching. So students need help to understand target language web texts and anticipate their structure and certain characteristics, which in turn will facilitate their reading and use of the web. The teachers should be aware of, let's say, poorly designed websites that may place undue frustration or cognitive load on the students, and that should be avoided. And teaching strategies should not end with the instruction in class. It should be revisited over time to foster independent and critical readers, and that's what our goal is here at DLI, yeah, to help them get to higher levels of language proficiency and specifically reading proficiency. So, any questions so far? Yes,
I wanted to ask you, based on your research, you do touch on it a little bit in your presentation. Has there been any evidence found, or at least did you find any evidence of online reading causing permanent shortening of the attention span, which then could affect the traditional textual reading?
Yeah, I didn't. You see, so they mentioned, like some studies mentioned, that there was negative effect of attention, yes? But this was not a specific variable explored in the research, yes? So that's why it can be, I mean, more research is needed. And then we need more research on second language reading, yes? Because it's not just reading per se,
yes.
Yeah? It's reading in the second language. So I didn't find, but I just saw, I think it was Carr's study, that they say it has negative effect on attention because the students, yeah, are looking everywhere, yes? And again, so here we're talking about online texts, not just the textbook using it in a screen format, yeah? But we have to remember that it may cause some negative effect, but it doesn't mean that we have to stop using online, yes? So because that's the world, yes? So, and the students are used to digital format, but at the same time, we don't want to completely ignore print.
No,
yes?
No.
Yeah. So, and this is because sometimes we're told, oh, don't use print textbooks. It's just like, don't speak English, yes? So it's an extreme when sometimes if your goal is to really ensure that they understand the text, take notes, go back to the notes. So it's not a bad idea. And the research supports that we need it, but we need both. And it's up to the teacher to see how you can balance both in the classroom or to give them as homework assignments. Yes? Yes, ma'am.
Yes, you said that you need more research in terms of that would explain why there's a negative effect. Do you know of any authors that is working on that line right now that doing more research as to answer the question of why?
Sutherland Smith has done a lot on, and I have some of the selected bibliography. So I highly recommend this one because she goes through all these studies, and it's a big help. As I said, so I was reading different papers up until a few weeks when I found this in the Journal of Research and Reading, and we have it at our DLI library, IESO library, have online this. So, and this is very recent. So she puts together, so you can look in her bibliography, but this was a group of researchers who also work on best practices in using online reading.
Do they have a comparative study also of metacognitive strategies for reading comprehension for both printed and online?
Yes, some do. Yeah, so they do. But again, so their goals are different. So if you want to explore something or do some research, I don't know, while taking some classes or just as for the fun of it, so this is one of the areas that is very, you know, open to research because there is not much there for now, especially in second language. Any more questions? Thank you very much.
Thank you.
So enjoy your lunch and know how to find me if you have more questions.
I would like to ask you to fill out the evaluation form, please. Just a couple of minutes.